under the lesson pollution, we have completed air pollution, and now the next part is the water pollution, and we have completed this part of Miss Canutel's question. Now we will see the next part, that is, water is said to be polluted. When we are saying that this water is polluted or it is not, then some identifications are there, just common identifications are there, just we are observing that. Scientifically we will see otherwise. So if gives the water gives the bad odor, if water gives the bad odor, if its color changes, waters, as you know that water color is, it is colorless, and if the water color change, then we can say that the water is polluted. Okay, then bad odor and water color changes, so these are the general things we, by observing the water, we can say that this water is polluted. Okay, now we will see here which things gave you in our textbook. So when we say that water said to be polluted, water is polluted, it becomes unclean and poisonous due to mixing of which things? Natural or artificial unwanted material. Natural means some plants are there, they grows on it, like what we are saying, like water hyacinth. Okay, and because of this, when it grows, it covers all the upper layer of the water, and because of it, what happens, the oxygen is not getting mixed in the water, and due to this, what happens, water get polluted. And artificial and unwanted material, artificial material inside which will come, if you think about it, then the artificial unwanted material means, if you see the factory's wastewater, factory wastewater or chemical mix water, this what happens without any processing, if we throw as it is in the river, otherwise any water resource, then we say that the water is get polluted. When it becomes harmful to living organism, for living organism, if it is harmful, then, and due to decreased oxygen content, if the oxygen is less in the water, then also we can say that the water is a polluted. When epidemic diseases are spread through water, the epidemic diseases are there, if it is spread through water, then we can say that this water is polluted. So to identify, just now I told you, it gives the bad odor and its color changes, then we say that water is polluted. And scientifically, when it becomes unclean, poisonous, or any natural or artificial unwanted material is added inside the water, otherwise when it becomes harmful to the living organism, after drinking that water the animals die, then we say that the water is what? Polluted. And oxygen content, if it is decreased from that, then we say that it is, the water is polluted water. Now fresh water and marine water pollutions includes physical, chemical and biological changes. Fresh water, that is that we are using for the drinking, this water is called as a fresh water. And marine water means the water, sea water. Which water? Sea water. Pollution includes physical, chemical and biological changes. So these changes are takes place inside the fresh water, otherwise the marine water, then we say that this water is the polluted water. Now which are the water pollutants? So we, by looking towards this picture, we can see that this water is polluted. Okay, because its color, see how many unwanted things are there, it is get added inside it, that's why this water is called as a polluted. So which things are there, those pollute the water? So first, biological pollutants. Water does not remain potable. Potable means drinkable. Potable means we can drink. So water does not remain potable due to algae, bacteria, viruses, parasites, etc. If these things are there, grow inside the water, which algae, bacteria, viruses, parasite, if it grows in the water, then these are the all biological, means these are living things, algae, bacteria, viruses and the parasite, and that's why it is called as a biological pollutants. If these things grow in the water, then we say that this water is polluted by the biological pollutants. And diseases are spread due to the biological pollution, and so many diseases are there like typhoid, cholera. Okay, these diseases are spread, diarrhea, vomiting, this is caused by these biological pollutants. Okay, afterwards, inorganic pollutants. So which are the inorganic pollutants? The suspended particles, the suspended particles. Which are the suspended particles? Fine sand, okay, dust particles, soil, precipitates of the salt. Okay, means so many salts are there, mineral salts are there, they are present in the soil, and because of that salt, what happens when it mix into the water, then we can say that it is an inorganic pollutant. Compounds of arsenic, cadmium, lead, mercury, okay, these are the chemicals which arsenic, cadmium, lead and mercury, these are very dangerous. Okay, some of these are the what, they emit some kinds of radiations and traces of radioactive material. Which are the radioactive material? That is uranium is there. If such a kind of things are there, it is added into the water, then we say that the water is polluted by the inorganic pollutants, and these are very dangerous to the all living organism. These means these radioactive substances, arsenic, cadmium, lead and mercury, if it is mixed into the water, then okay. Now next it is the organic pollutants. Organic pollutant. So organic pollutants inside weedicides. Okay, the chemical which is used to kill the weeds from the farm, these are called as a weedicides. Insecticides, the chemicals used to kill the insect, those are called as a insecticides. Fertilizers, sewage, dirty water, otherwise the household water. Industrial influence are there. If it is added into the water, then we say that the these pollutants are called as a organic pollutant. So in exam they may be ask you, name the following insects. This question they may be ask you, so write the biological pollutant. So at that time you have to write these names like algae, bacteria, viruses and the parasite. If they are asking to you inorganic pollutants, you have to write this name like fine sand, dust, soil, precipitates of the salts, the compounds like arsenic, cadmium, lead and the mercury, okay, and traces of the radioactive material. These names you have to write for. If organics are there, then weedicides, insecticides, fertilizers and sewage, industrial influence, etc., these are called as the organic pollutants. Next, do you know? Large number of tanning centers are present in the Tamil Nadu. Which centers? The tanning centers are present in the Tamil Nadu, and wastewater from those centers is released into the Palar River, and hence the river get referred by the Pazar, that is a gutter river. Means it is like a very dull, dirty water is there inside it. So that river is like a gutter river because of this tanning. Okay, the next it is a, what are the reasons of water pollution? Just now we seen some of the pollutants, these are responsible for the pollution of the water, and now we will see some natural and the man-made reasons of the water pollution. So first of all we will focus on this natural reasons of the water pollution. So first it is the aquatic weeds, unwanted plants. Okay, weeds is called as a unwanted plants. In farm also what happens, we accept a crop, some other plants are growing, and these are called as a weeds. Now these weeds are there, aquatic weeds are there, those grows in the water, those are called as the aquatic weeds. Because of the aquatic weeds, what happens? Depletion of O2 level. As you know that so many living organisms are there, like fish, okay, and the that is tortoise, they are living in the water. Why they are living in the water? As we all know that all living things need the oxygen for their existence. Then from where is the oxygen is coming inside the water? From the air, some water is get mixed into the what? Some oxygen is get mixed into the water, and that oxygen is available to these aquatic animals. Okay, and they are taking this by using the gills. They are taking this water from the mouth. They are taking the water and gills, they are throwing it outside, and in this process the oxygen from the water they absorb it. Okay, and that is possible. And due to this aquatic weeds, what happens? The oxygen level from the water deplete becoming less. Next up, changes in the natural quality of water. As you know that water is what? It doesn't have any particular taste. Okay, tasteless, odorless, colorless is water. Okay, actually these are the properties of the water. And if there are changes in the natural quality of water, natural quality of water is change because of this aquatic weeds. So this is the aquatic weeds. This is the natural reason of the what? Water pollution. Next, it is the decomposing matter. As we know that some animals, some plants, what happens? Die. Okay, and when they die, their body decomposing, and their body when decomposes, what happens? Its body may mix into the water if it is present inside the water then, and due to this what happens? The decomposing matters also pollute the water. Okay, next it is the mud and the sludge. Mud or sludge, river current and its diversion. So what happens when in rainy season, most of the time when the river flows from the high level to the low level, it carries the small particles of the soil with it. Okay, and that particles it, and if you see in rainy season, the color of the river is also changes. It looks what? Reddish in color, and because the water particles are muddy, it looks because the water small particles of the mud or the soil is present inside it, and due to this what happens? The water polluted, means river current and its diversion. And if the water, suppose it is generally flowing in this way, just we are saying like Nile River, if it changes its way, then what happens? On this way, if any dirty things are there and pollutants are there, it makes into the water and water get polluted. Next, soil erosion. You know that the soil erosion takes place because of the which? The water, rivers. Okay, when the river moves from the mountainous region, generally all the rivers are there, their origin is in the mountainous region only. Okay, so when it when these rivers origin at that from that place, it moves towards the what? Plain region. As it is a property of water, it always flow from higher level to the lower level. Okay, so when it flows with it, it carries the particles or the small pebbles with it, and due to this what happens? The soil erosion, and soil also good quality of soil what happens is carry with it, and this is due to this what happens? The water pollute. So many biotic, abiotic factors, biotic and abiotic means animals also, small animals, and abiotic factor means soil. Okay, added to the water due to soil erosion, means with this soil what happens? These particles are also what happens? Get mixed into the water, and this is soil erosion also the reason of the water pollution. Next, it is the microbes like fungi and the bacteria. As we know that if water is stagnant for some time, it is not moving, it remains as it is, then fungi and bacteria grow inside it, and its color changes. Okay, and due to this also water is polluted, and here they gave the growth of organic matter decaying inside the water. These organic matters when decay inside the water, then water get polluted. Sixth point is the algae. Excessive growth of the algal growth pollutes the water. Okay, so this, if suppose pond is there and such a kind of water hyacinth like otherwise algae grows on it, it covers whole this pond. It covers whole the pond, and due to this what happens? The oxygen is not mixing inside the water, and oxygen level of the water decreases, means what happens? It gets polluted. Next is the nematodes. So soil nematodes flow in the rain water. So these nematodes means these are like worms. These are like worm, earthworm, how it is there, like these worms are there. These are called as a nematodes, and they grow on the what? They are microscopic, and they grow on the tiny microscopic plants and the animals, and that's why what happens? These are, they also what happens? Water pollutes. Okay, so these are the natural reasons of the water pollution. After that, we will move towards the man-made reasons of the water pollution. So here inside the man-made reasons, domestic sewage. In our home, we are washing clothes, taking bath, so all this water enter inside the gutters, and that gutter water enter inside the small river is there in our Vaduz, the Yerala river is there, and all this water that all from Vaduz water what happens, it enters into the Yarana River, and due to this also what happens, the water get polluted. Same thing is happening in every city where the rivers are located. So domestic sewage is also the one of the reason which pollute the water, and it includes the human, it is because of the human activities. So domestic sewage from villages and the cities is disposed of in the river water. So these things are there, we are disposing in the river water, the river get polluted or the water pollutes. Next it is the industrial influence. So which are the industrial influence? Various pigments, the pigments they are using for the different for coloring, for bleaching. Okay, so these pigment, the bleaching chemicals, okay, then leather pieces, fibers, mercury, lead are released into the water. Okay, so these things are produced in the industries, various industries, textile industry, sugar industries are there, after steel industries. Inside is these chemicals they are using, which like bleaching powder and leather pieces are developed in the leather industry is there, fibers are there, mercury, lead, etc. And it is what happens, it is released into water. Then these are the industrial products that causes the what? Water pollution. Next it is the oil spillage. Oil spillage means what happens, sometimes as you know that these oils are there, petroleum oil, petroleum and all, it is carried by the ships. Okay, and due to some reasons if accident takes place, then oil gets spills on the surface of the seawater. On the surface of seawater, when it mix, as we know that the water and the oil, they are not mixing each other, so it forms a layer of the oil on that water. Okay, and due to this what happens, the contact of the air and the water is what breaks because of the layer of oil, and due to this what happens, the oxygen is not get mixing inside the water, so it is very dangerous oil spill. So this they told us, it is also cause the water pollution. While transportation, cleaning of the tankers or tankers, oil spill into the water, and due to this water polluted. Next fourth point is the uses of fertilizers and pesticides. To get more amount of crop, what we are doing, we are using some fertilizers and the pesticides in our farm, and inside it which N for nitrogen, P for phosphorus and K for potassium. These things are present in that chemical fertilizers. Okay, if we are using the chemical fertilizers and the pesticides, then inside it chemicals are present. Most nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, they contains the chemical fertilizers. Pesticides like endrine, chlorine, carbonate containing pesticides flow with the water, and water get polluted. As we know that the water, what happens, these chemicals are there, they mix into the water, and water have a tendency when it seeps into the ground, and that water, the chemical fertilizers with water enter inside the groundwater, and when we are taking this water for drinking, then that water is a polluted water. Okay, and the last reason are the other reasons, and inside it disposal of human waste. As you know, the toilet water, okay, that also where enters in the these waters only. Washing of clothes, then decomposing hemps and the flex they are making, no, inside it, so that also chemicals using in water. Disposal of ashes, okay, some persons die, then what happens, that that ash of that person's body, when they're burning the body, after that remaining ash, some peoples, they have the some beliefs are there, they are throwing in the rivers like Ganga, otherwise any holy river, and due to this also water get polluted. Floral offering to the god means that when we are giving the visiting the temples, at that time we are using the what's garlands of the flower, and these flower garlands, what happens, we are throwing inside the water, and due to this also water pollutes. And water from the thermal power plant, and the thermal power plant inside this water is there, that water what happens, pollute the water. Okay, so these are the some reasons that we seen, the reasons of water pollution, and for the in that reason, some are natural reasons and some are man-made reasons. Natural reasons we cannot control, but man-made reasons are there. If we do some activities, then we can reduce the pollution takes place by the man-made reason. Okay, so today we'll stop here only. All of you learn these reasons of the man-made and the natural reasons of the water pollution. So today we'll stop here only. Okay, thank you and have a good day.